Live from the north side of Chicago, Wrigley Field, we've got baseball on the show. It's the St. Louis Cardinals and the Chicago Cubs. First pitch coming your way next. All right, first pitch coming up. Our starter in this one, Ben Brown. What do we need to know here about the right-hander?
Well, they're going with the opener in this one, so this is an interesting look. He's probably only going to pitch an inning, maybe two at the most, and it's going to be unconventional. I think he's going to pitch backwards, more off speed, and then fastballs late.
All right, ready to get underway. Now the left fielder, Brendan Donovan. And the pitch. Now a check swing, but he held up.
2-1.
That pitch in for a strike. It's 2-2. Stays alive. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
And now the right fielder, Alec Burleson. One down, base is empty. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Righty to the plate. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. One out, base is empty. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Well, there appears to be no problem settling in on the mound out there today. It looks pretty tough to start this one. Punched out the first two hitters of this ball game, and somebody's going to have to put the bat on the ball, put it in play, and get something going.
Two outs. That one fouled off. 2-2. The wind and the pitch. Battling here as he fouls it away. Two down, nobody on. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock.
Oh, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there.
Really good swing right there.
He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
On the north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. Here's Nolan Gorman. Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair. Body hooks foul.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Left-hand batter waits. And a swing and a miss. And that is that. So one left for the Cardinals. And now it'll be the Cubs' turn in a scoreless ball game. Major League Baseball is on the show. Back here at the friendly confines. And on the mound in this one, Kyle Gibson.
Well, this guy's got sort of a tweener, not quite a slider velocity and not as slow as a curve. It's in between, and he adds and subtracts velocity on it, which makes it harder for the hitters to really get that front foot down and have the timing they need to be successful.
So up now for Chicago, Mike Tauchman. Out to short, win. Jump throw across his body, and a quick out number one. Here's a look at the Cubs lineup. The sluggers of this lineup might not be too happy about the fact that the wind is blowing in today, Chris.
Yeah, and you hear pitchers talk about how good it feels when the wind is at their back. And for hitters, you almost feel like beyond just the pitcher coming at you, you've got this other force coming against you. So important to try to get on top of the ball in terms of hitting line drives, you know, maybe really hard ground balls with a good exit velocity that'll get you a base hit, because it's very frustrating. You just hit one on the screws, think it's going to go out of the ballpark, and a guy is camped underneath it in front of the warning track.
Two away.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
1-1 now.
Ball. Two balls, one strike.
And that one fouled off. Two outs, base is empty. Next offering is downstairs. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And it's a three up, three down inning. And the Cubs are down in order. Scoreless after one. Here at Wrigley Field, here's Nolan Arenado. When you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list.
Stud. When you look at players like this, you play that hot corner, got to be pretty courageous over there with the way balls come off the bat. That's the kind of guy that every year you expect him to be in the All-Star game and have a gold glove, if not a platinum glove.
Hap heads towards it. He's got it. One away.
The designated hitter, Matt Carpenter.
Now it's Matt Carpenter. No score here in the second. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Tuchman makes the grab, and there's two away.
The shortstop, Mason.
And stepping in for the Cardinals, Mason Wynn. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. The 1-1 is fouled off.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
The shortstop takes the ball. Tapped softly on the ground. Whips it across. And that is the third out of the inning. So they make short work of them there. We go to the bottom of inning number two. No score. Back here at Wrigley Field, bottom half of inning number two. Here's the third baseman, Christopher Morel. Swinging a foul straight back. The pitch. On the ground to third. Leadoff man retired here in the second. Ian Happ up to hit.
Happ, a switch hitter. It can be challenging for guys at the big league level to maintain a good swing from both sides of the plate. Clearly, he's got more pop from the left side, but in 2022, the right side was respectable as well.
Two balls, one strike.
The wind of the pitch. And another ball. And he deals. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Line drive, caught!
Yikes, that ball was scorched. An absolute missile. It almost becomes self-defense as the fielder when one of those things comes screaming towards you. Watch your lips.
Dansby Swanson stands in. Two outs. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. And a pitch. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Two down, nobody on.
That's ball two. 2-2 to count.
On the ground, and that's just foul. Righty delivers. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. That one ripped. That's back there. Into the bleachers and gone. That was blasted to the moon. Just like that, they move in front. It's 1-0. He absolutely crushed that one.
No doubt about that one, Boog. We knew it wasn't coming back. A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got over.
Base is empty with two away. Michael Busch, the next cup to hit. Fastball for a strike. And the count's even at 2. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. Two down, base is empty, but one run across, bottom half of inning number 2. Out to short, Wynn. Tosses to first, that's the third out. Cubs get one on the solo shot. It's now 1-0. And we're back, all set for the start of the inning. And now it's Ivan Herrera. And a 1-1. There's a swing and a drive. Pat ranging back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
And he hammered that to straightaway center field. It's a deep part of the ballpark. Tell you what, that wind is blowing straight in. Got to be a big man if you're going to go through the wind of that part of the park. It just knocked that ball down.
California kid, played for his dad at Elk Grove High School. His teammates there with Nick Madrigal. And that one is lifted in the air. And he makes the catch. And there's two down.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Back to the top of the lineup, Brendan Donovan. Next up for the Cardinals. That's in there. It's a ball and two strikes.
So far, all we've seen in this at bat are fastballs. Look for him to slow it down right here ahead in the count.
And that one almost hit him.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Now a high fly ball out to left center. Bellinger drifts towards it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom of the inning. Now it's going to be Nico Horner. That one hit to right. Burleson under it. Hauls it in for the out. And there's one away.
Batting ninth. The catcher.
And now it's Miguel Amaya. One down, base is empty. That one ripped, but foul. Ground ball, Goldie. Steps on first for the out.
Now batting, right fielder, Mike Tuchman.
Back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. Here's Mike Tuchman. And the righty deals. Now a fly ball to right center. Tracks it down for the out. And that's the third out. To the fourth. Now it's the right fielder, Alec Burleson.
Alec Burleson.
The wind of the pitch. Bounced out to short. Throws across the diamond. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
And here's Paul Goldschmidt. The Cubbies up by a run. Top half of inning number four. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. This one in the air. Bush settles under it. Snags it for the second out.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Nolan Gorman. He provides a surprising amount of pop from the second base position.
Listen, that's not something to take lightly. Getting that kind of production from the guys up the middle, it's not a strength of most lineups.
And what does that do for a team when you get power from unexpected spots like that?
When you're in the dugout and you see a guy come up big like that you don't necessarily expect it, it just energizes that entire team.
And it goes just foul. Two-two. Waves at the bender for the strikeout. Redbirds down quietly. They're down 1-0. Ready to go, bottom four. And here's the DH for the Cubs, Seiya Suzuki. One and two here. Gets a piece there, we'll do it again. Pitch stays alive. The pitch bows it back with two strikes.
That was a really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
Next pitch is outside. It's a good take. The pitch. And another ball.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Decides to hold on to it, and they catch a break as they get a base runner at first. Here's Cody Bellinger.
Here's a 1-1. You know, these Cubs did a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of him. He's only given up one run, but the starter's pitch count is starting to get up there, and that might be the best news yet for this offense.
Kicks and fires. Fouls one off. 2-2. Suzuki aboard here at first with nobody out. And a pitch. Foul off the plate. They'll do it again. And the right-hander deals. And that just misses.
You know, sometimes all it takes is getting to the next arm before an offense does any damage. And that might be the case today.
3-2. That one out to right. Burleson makes the play.
The first baseman, number five, Christopher Morel.
Now the third baseman, Christopher Morel. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. That's in for a strike. Throw. Save. Runner at second here. One gone. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. And it beats him for out number two. That's a strikeout.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count up at two balls and two strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
Ian Happ, the next Cub to hit. Right-hander kicks, deals. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Donovan hauls it in to end the inning. Cubs leave one, but they lead it 1-0. New inning getting started. Here's Nolan Arenado. Here's a 1-1. And that one upstairs. Activity in the bullpen. Javier Assad appears to be getting loose. Hodge getting cranked up as well. pitch. Swings and misses. What a way.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Now it's the DH, Matt Carpenter. The why to kick the pitch. Hey. That misses. The count now 2-2. Wouldn't chase that time. Payoff pitch. That's a laser base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Up next, the part
dominant performance for him today, Boog. Just two hits allowed so far, no runs across either, and he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced, so I don't think this hit is going to knock him off his stride too much.
Runner on at first with one gone, and stepping in is the speedy Mate. Runner takes off, swing and a miss.
One ball.
Throw to second.
I think that was a hit and run right there. When you look at how far that pitch was out of the zone and the hitter still trying to put wood on it, put it in play, that tells you that they had something going. But unfortunately, it was a good job of execution by the pitcher and the catcher to get that out of the zone and then throw out the runner at second base. Really nice job behind the dish.
Two outs. Fouls it off, still 1-2.
Looking sharp, just a strike away from five shutout innings.
Here comes a pitch. That misses. 2-2.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
And here it comes. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. The throw is still in time. And even with his speed, they get the out. Here at Wrigley Field, John Schaumbi with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, Dansby Swanson. The wind and the pitch. Flips the corner. 1-2.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
And that's in the dirt. Kicks and deals. Got him. And that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth. So up next, Michael Busch.
The first baseman, Michael Busch.
And another ball.
Not a lot of people know this, but this isn't the only Wrigley Field in MLB history. You know, when the league expanded and added the Los Angeles Angels in 1961, they played their first season at a stadium in L.A. called Wrigley Field, which had been the home of the minor league team of the same name.
One down, base is empty. That one just misses the outside corner. And now it's 3-2. And down on strikes. Home half of the fifth inning moving along. Two quick outs. Here's Nico Horner. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. Two down, nobody on. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
High, and the count is 2-2. When you look at the elite teams in the game right now, there is going to be the slug, no question about it. But the really good offensive teams combine slug with more contact, with less swing and miss. And it stays fair.
Just one of those seam high base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
Runner at first with two away. Now here is Miguel Amaya.
Yeah, and the domino effect of that is running up pitch counts on pitchers and then either getting them to a place of fatigue or getting into the bullpen perhaps before you get to those higher leverage arms at the back end.
Pitch out. But no action. The pitch. Horner on the go. Swing and a miss. Safe at second, and that was not close. Horner stands at second with two gone. Next pitch is outside. One of the things that Jim Leland used to say when I was broadcasting with the Marlins, the longer a plate appearance goes for a batter, the more likely it is that something good will happen for the hitter. Man at second. Ripped to third. In plenty of time to first. What a play. Inning over. One hit, one left. We're through five. It's the Cubs 1 and the Cardinals nothing. All right, we go to the top half of inning number 6. And here's the catcher, Ivan Herrera. That one well upstairs. 3-1. And there's ball 4.
Take the break.
That could jumpstart an offense that's really struggled to score in this one. Don't want to wake a team up with the free pass.
This is Dylan Carlson. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. On the ground to third. Off balance speed. There's one. Over to first. Safe.
Tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Ben Brown will depart. Only 2 hits allowed for him, so a great effort. And we'll be back after a quick break to tell you about the new arm. New pitcher now, Drew Smyly.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings.
Back to the leadoff spot in the St. Louis lineup. Brendan Donovan next up for the Cardinals. Line drive, and that's a fair ball. Lead runner makes the turn at second. Lead runner holds at third, so 2 runners in scoring position and just 1 out.
Well, that may end up being an at-bat we go back to later on when this game is over. That was a thing of beauty. He may have been a little behind the pitch, but by getting that barrel into the hitting zone early on in his swing, he was able to meet it and still shoot a line drive down the line and left. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
So 2 in scoring position with 1 out. Now the number 2 hitter, Alec Burleson. swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, this is where the team aspect really comes into play on the offensive side of the game, right? I mean, missed opportunity to tie it up with the runner at third, one out, couldn't put the ball in play. So now it's time to pick him up. And that's where good teams, they go to. They operate on this level of next man up. That mentality is what causes them to win series, get into the postseason. That helps keep the energy and morale high in the dugout.
Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. That one back up the middle, and it gets through. One runs in. Fires to the plate. He's in there. It's 2-1.
Big one there as he drives in a couple of runs. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Now up for St. Louis, Nolan Gorman. Out towards left center. Ham sizing this one up. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. But two runs for him, and they jump ahead. Top of the order, two up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Cardinals 2 and the Cubs 1. Well, we go bottom six. Stepping in, Mike Tauchman. Left-hand batter waits.
Well, after giving up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Next offering is down low. Action in the St. Louis bullpen. Kyle Leahy appears to be getting ready, and I'm sure he's feeling some nerves. This would be his major league debut. Number 64, also getting ready. Just off the inside edge.
That's a really good take.
Seiya Suzuki waiting to hit for the Cubs. And here's a 3-2. That one misses. So a leadoff walk.
His ability to draw walks has been something. It's been part of his career since day one.
Here's Oliver Marmol towards the mound, and we're going to see a pitching change here. That'll be it for Kyle Gibson. Gave him a good effort as he exits with a lead. And we'll have a new pitcher when we come back. Kyle Leahy taking over on the mound.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing out of him right here to get some critical outs.
No outs. Runner at first. Seiya Suzuki now at the plate. With the go-ahead run at the plate here in the bottom of the sixth. Swings through that one out in front that time.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way. And it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done. Now a pretty big at bat coming up with a chance to even this ball game up.
Bellinger up to hit. And a pitch. That's towards center. Carlson settles underneath it. Drops into the glove.
Now batting, the third baseman, Christopher Morrell.
Two on, one out. Next to hit, Christopher Morrell. And a pitch.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, boy.
Two on, one out. Got him! Two out.
Well, you got to be ready to swing the bat with a runner in scoring position and two strikes. Just put the ball in play somewhere, and you got a chance. Very frustrating for him, I'm sure. See if the next guy can pick him up.
Digging in is the switch inning outfielder, Ian Happ. Way upstairs, and that's ball two.
A little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his back down just enough to make contact with that pitch to keep the at-bat alive.
Two on, two outs. Swing and a fly ball in the air out towards right center field. Makes the grab. That is the inning. Cubs strand a couple. They're down 2-1. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Javier Assad. Now,
pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Here's the third baseman, Nolan Arenado.
The third baseman, Nolan Arenado.
The 1-1.
No bets off the plate. Ball
the Cubs in. Bullpen with some action. Number 43 getting loose out there. Wisniewski also throwing. Wouldn't That's chase that time.
Three balls, one strike.
See another payoff pitch. Ripped to short. In time to Bush, and they get Arenado for the out.
Now that designated hitter, Matt.
So now here's the Cardinals' designated hitter, Matt Carpenter. Base is empty, one away here in the top half of inning number seven. Pulls that one foul. And he deals. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Wind of the pitch. Not even close there. And it's 2-2. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
That misses the zone. Full count now. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Now he turns and heads for second. The throw in. And he'll reach second with one away.
Put a really nice balanced swing on it. And when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box. And he'll feel real good about that one.
And it's second with one away. And up next for St. Louis, Mason Wynn. Good eye right there.
Ball.
Man at second. That one fouled off, 2-2. Righty to the plate. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Right-handed reliever. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Righty delivers. And another ball. Into center. On the move. Get there, base hit. Roll into third, in there safely.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I could see already is bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
First and third, one down. That just misses. 2-1.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
The pitch. Just missed.
He's getting a little frustrated out there on the mound, getting hit around a little bit. Let's see if he can settle himself down.
Carpenter on third. Win at first. One gone. And that is in for a strike. 3-2 down.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up. Get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Inside ball four.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate. The game plan that he's sticking to is just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
Dylan Carlson next up for the Cardinals. The pitch. Swings and pulls it foul to the right side. One out, base is full. Swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there. At the plate, Brendan Donovan.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
And a pitch. And another ball.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit. Just not able to square it up.
Comes a 2-2. And a swing and a miss. That ends the inning as they squander a chance to pick up some insurance.
He's in a tough spot, had to make a great pitch, did it, got the strikeout, gets out of the jam. Clearly, he's happy with those results.
Looking to get the tying run on base. Swinging a foul over the screen and back out of play. The wind of the pitch. Got him looking. That's a strikeout. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
And up next for Chicago, Michael Busch. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Here comes a 3-2. Fights it off. You'll see another. Three and two now. Goes down looking.
Frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Nico Horner, the next cup to hit. Two outs. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Kicks and fires. Just a weak fly ball this time. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that is the inning. Cubs are down quietly. And our score remains 2-1. We're at the top of the eighth. And now the right fielder, Alec Burleson.
Alec Burleson.
Clips the outside corner. And the count 1-2. And another ball. And down on strikes he goes. Looks like he's picked up right where he left off.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
Next pitch is outside. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. So the bullpen doing a nice job backing up the effort from their starter.
Yeah, we've seen some pretty excellent pitching out of this staff so far. I mean, they've come in ready to do their job and get outs. They've been pretty tough to get to in this one.
Two down, nobody on. Off the mark there. Now two balls and a strike.
One strike.
Ripped towards third. Sends it across to first. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. They lead it 2-1. Andrew Kittredge on a pitch out of the pen here.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves. Late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Well, one run game, and here is Miguel Amaya. And a pitch. And a foul ball left side. Two two now.
Down to 3-2.
Moved into the bullpen for the Cardinals. Ryan Helsley preparing to come on if needed. Romero, the power lefty, up as well.
Out
got him swinging.
Pretty big strikeout right there to start this eighth inning. Down one. Any leadoff base runner really makes this inning a bit more interesting. But now this offense has to switch from possibly trying to manufacture a run to needing to run into something or just try to string multiple hits together to get a run across the plate.
Here's the Cubs leadoff man, Mike Tauchman. One down, base is empty. Back to right. And it drops in.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when a team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. He clearly didn't catch that one on the big part of the bat. Just kind of muscled it out there. And, you know, on the mound, it can be pretty frustrating for a pitcher, but you just kind of have to expect those to drop in there sometimes.
Making a move at first, entering as the pinch runner, Pete Crow Armstrong. One down, runner at first. Seiya Suzuki, the next Cub to hit. Kittredge, keeping an eye on him.
He's got plus speed, but in this situation, all eyes are going to be over there trying to keep his lead tight.
That one catches the zone, and the count is even 2-2.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
And the righty deals. 3-2 now.
So here we go. Base runner at first. Could be running on the pitch. He's got good enough speed to steal the bag to get in scoring position, even if it's a swing and miss at the plate.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And that one hit to first. And it's through for a hit. Lead runner touches second, headed for third. And it throws offline, safe at third.
Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole. A chance now to even the score and maybe extend this game.
Here comes Cody Bellinger.
And things could change quickly here with one swing.
One out, the tying and go-ahead runs are on here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Wouldn't chase that time.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Ripped into right center for a base hit. The tying run is in to score from third. It's 2-2.
Such great concentration. Everybody on their feet, knowing that you can come through with a good swing. And there, he doesn't try to do too much.
Number 64 gets the call from the pen.
Now pitching for the Cardinals, number 64, Ryan Fernandez.
Now, Christopher Morel. Two on, one out. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, Ian Happ. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure. He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
The pitch. Swing and high fly ball to left. Squeezes it. Runner tagging and heading for home. He'll score on the sac fly. It's 3-2.
Well, that's a quality at bat right there. You know the situation. You need something in the air and deep enough, and that's exactly what he did. Good pass to the baseball.
Up first and second with two outs. And next for the Cubs, Dansby Swanson. The pitch. Got him looking. Good job at damage control right there. A couple of runs in the inning puts them ahead. Through eight full, it's the Cubs 3 and the Cardinals 2. So coming into the game now on defense, Pete Crow Armstrong. He takes over and right.
throw or strike.
So they turn to the veteran pitcher in this spot, Hector Neris.
Now this is an extremely confident pitcher. He loves the pressure. Actually likes the one-run game better than a comfortable three-run save opportunity because that's when he pitches his best.
Lifted in the air right center field. Makes the grab, run away.
That's such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
One down, base is empty. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Gets a piece and stays alive. A one-run lead here at the top of the ninth. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout. And the batter will be the shortstop, Mason Wynn.
Now this guy, a player that if he gets on base, has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
And that one clips the corner.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
The Cards down to their final strike. Up the middle, and he knocks it down. And they get it out after the ricochet. And that is the ball game.
All these players were able to take the lead in the bottom of the eighth and just cruise to this win, getting those final three outs at the top of the ninth. Excellent job of securing your home field and keeping the fans in the ball game all the way to the end. Nice W all the way around.
3-2 the final score. They hang on to win it by a run. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.
Here now is our final high score this afternoon. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. Three runs on seven hits. No errors. They left.